Welcome. In this video, we will explain how to use Renderpool for Blender cycles. Renderpool is a GPU cloud rendering service which renders Blender cycles and Radeon ProRender plugin scenes in a fraction of the time it would take on your local machine. Our servers are built and optimized for rendering to help you minimize your rendering times and costs. In the event that you have an animation that you need to finish within a specified time frame, but said animation may take more than one day to render, meaning you might not make that deadline, Renderpool can be the solution you're looking for. You'll be able to work on other scenes while Renderpool renders your animation in the background, giving you more time to focus on creation rather than utility management. This video will explain the Renderpool process step by step, what to prepare in Blender, how to use Renderpool, and finally, show a time comparison of rendering with our service against rendering locally. First off, let's look into preparation. This section is divided up into three parts for a more comprehensive understanding on how to upload to Renderpool from Blender without any issue. The first step is to pack your resources. The pack resources function is a feature in Blender that archives your texture files into your .blend file. This is commonly used to transfer .blend scenes from one computer to another. This way, all you need to copy is your .blend file. Go to File, External Data, and pack resources. After doing this, the textures you've imported to your .blend scene will be packed together into the file, allowing for easy transfer. You can confirm this by comparing the file size from before and after packing your resources, as well as confirming the change of the icon on the image texture node inside your shader editor. Keep in mind that there are files that cannot be packed the same way, which would be image sequences or cached files, which are something like these. These files are too heavy to be packed as resources, so these will have to be separate. For those who do not have any sequenced or cached files, you can ignore this step. For the second step, you will need to set relative paths. If there are any files that don't share the same folder as your Blend file, please close Blender first and move the files to where your Blend file is located. For example, it cannot be like this. It has to be like this. Reopen Blender and go to File, External Data, Find Missing Files, and select the cache folder's location. After that, go to File, External Data, and make paths relative. When these files are made relative, the cached file path should change from absolute to relative. The third and final step is setting the file output. The file output is for configuring exports for other render passes that aren't specified by the composite node. By using this, you can export AOV passes to be used for composition later in your preferred photo or video editing software. Any output set here can also be rendered out in Renderpool. After completing these three steps, your file should be ready for upload. For those with files that cannot be packed into a .blend file alone, please be sure to compress your project into a zip or 7-zip file that includes all necessary files as mentioned earlier. You can check for yourself if you perform these steps correctly by transferring the resulting zip file to another computer or just copying the project to another location. If there are no other missing textures or absolute path issues, you're ready to upload your file to Renderpool.